So we know a little bit about the DNA code and how it actually works and how it's regulated. But one of the things that we need to talk about is when something goes wrong with that code. And back when we talked about evolution, we defined a mutation as a small change in the DNA code. But I want to talk a little bit more about those mutations now. So a DNA mutation is a mistake in the DNA code. And it could happen in a couple different ways. You can get a copying error by DNA polymerase. So when DNA is making a copy of itself, it inserts the wrong base. Could be that you have an A and it's supposed to put in a T, but instead it jams a G in there. There are enzymes that proofread your DNA, but every once in a while they might miss one of these errors. The other place we get mutations is through radiation and chemical exposure. And both of these physically knock nucleotides out of the DNA sequence. Radiation waves are going to hit that A and knock it out of the code completely. Chemical exposure, chemicals will interfere with or react with a particular nucleotide, and so it gets removed from the sequence. This kind of chemical exposure creates something called a frameshift mutation. A frameshift mutation results from losing a nucleotide or adding a new one in, and it changes the reading frame of your DNA. Remember, the codons are read three letters at a time. So if you add a fourth letter, you're going to completely change how you would read that particular frame, and it changes the entire meaning of the code. So let me give you a silly but illustrative example of this. Here we have a sentence that's based on a three-letter code. The cat ate the rat. And we read that in three-letter segments so that it makes sense. If we have a copying error, we're going to change one of the letters. So let's say we change this letter from a C to a K. Now, this doesn't make perfect sense anymore, but we can still kind of figure out what's going on. And if we created a protein from this, we would still get something similar. But now let's take this out completely. Now, if we read our three-letter code, the first one is fine, but the rest of the sentence doesn't make any sense at all. We've lost what would be our stop codon, and so this kind of mutation can cause massive damage to cells, and this is why exposure to extreme chemicals and radiation can cause cell death, because you're going to scramble your DNA and you're not going to be able to make the proper proteins. The effects of mutations can also vary. Can be that there's absolutely no effect at all. So you can have a change, but no effect. Could be a partial change, or could result in cell death. You can have no effect due to a DNA mutation if the mutation's to a part of DNA that doesn't code for a protein. Remember, we just talked about those intron sections that get spliced out? If you get a mutation to that section, then it doesn't matter. There are also large sections of the DNA that don't specifically code for proteins. Now, we used to call that junk DNA. It turns out those non-coding sections are very important in controlling which genes are turned on when. It could be that the code changes, but there's not a resulting amino acid change. Remember that we said DNA is a redundant code. And for example, there's two different ways here to get proline. So if your code change was an A to a G, you're still going to get the same amino acid and thus the same protein. It could be that the amino acid changes. It changes from proline to serine, but if those both have the same basic chemical characteristics, maybe they're both hydrophilic, it's not going to change the overall shape of the protein and thus the function, and so there won't really be an effect for that DNA mutation. It could be that the mutation does alter the protein somewhat. Maybe it changes one amino acid, or it changes two amino acids, but the protein still appears to function. It could be that it changes the protein enough that it doesn't work at all, but the protein is not so essential for the cell. Finally, if a DNA mutation prevents an essential protein from forming or functioning properly, then it's going to result in cell death. Now, When you look at this list, mutations sound bad, but also remember DNA mutations are one of the sources of variation in populations. And particularly if you imagine you get some situation like this where it alters a protein, but not too severely, if the environment changes, possibly this altered protein will give that particular individual an advantage in a particular environment. So I hope you look back at this overview and have it make a little bit more sense now as we go from DNA to RNA to proteins, and proteins then make lipids, carbohydrates, and more DNA and RNA. This is as fundamental as molecular biology gets. I mentioned that this is a universal code. And I just want to reiterate this by showing you a couple experiments that people have done. So, fireflies have a gene for a protein called luciferin, which glows. And what some researchers did is they spliced out the firefly gene and they inserted it into this tobacco plant. And now the tobacco plant is glowing. It is expressing that gene. So once a gene is in a cell, it doesn't matter who it came from, the cell can follow those directions, use its RNA polymerase, and build whatever protein it's coded for. Here we have a pig expressing a jellyfish glowing gene. Notice it's only glowing in its hooves and its nose. They inserted this gene next to another gene they were interested in. They're able to look at this pig and know when the gene of interest is being expressed because glowing is also happening in those cells. This is actually a preview of a biotechnology technique we'll talk about next week. It sounds a little crazy to make things glow, but it's actually a really important technique in understanding which genes are being expressed in certain kinds of cells. And I just think it's an amazing illustration of the fact that our DNA code is truly universal. I'd like you to watch this video one more time. I know you watched it once before, but hopefully you'll go through and the parts will make a lot more sense as you've gone through all of the details of transcription, translation, and gene expression.